Praise the Lord. Brother Raymond, would you open with a prayer, please?
Lord, we thank you for this other day of life. We thank you for this Lord's Day that the Lord has made us rejoice in it. Pray, Lord, we come here today to worship you in spirit and in truth. You help here today to do that. Give us our failures and our shortcomings and help us. Lay aside the cares of this life, Lord. It's my focus upon you here this morning. That your name might be lifted up above all names, might draw men unto you. We pray for the preaching today. Bless Brother Brad as he breaks the bread of life to us here today. Give him that fresh anointing in each one of us, Lord. In the end, we might say it's been good to be in the house of the Lord today. We might be encouraged. Remember those today, Lord, that are sick in body. We lift them up to you the only way we know how. We know today you're in a great position that you look in on. Lord, you might touch them. They might be made whole in the same self-hour, Lord, that they might be whole. We pray, Lord, for every soul that don't know you today in that free pardon of sin. We know that you died for all of them. We pray for all, Lord, that the Spirit of joy may help them realize the condition of the soul. They might call upon you before it's too late. We invite you into service now. We pray and ask these things and give thanks in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you. everlasting to everlasting.
This week, I don't know if at one point, but for some reason I felt led I wanted to preach on this. I don't have a fancy outline, I don't have anything fancy here, but Lord laid on my heart, I believe it's a big problem we have in our world today. We're going to find in Philippians chapter 2, talks about Jesus. He made himself of no reputation. We'll start here in verse 7. But he made himself of no reputation. He took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of man. You know, God came down and did that for us.
Yeah.
And being found in fashion as a man, verse 8, he says, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Jesus did that for you and I.
Yeah.
Verse 9 says, wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. Verse 11 says, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
A couple weeks ago, I preached on God's grace. And I shared that you ought to share some grace. We ought to be graceful towards one another.
Yeah.
Aren't you glad for God's grace this morning?
Amen.
Praise the Lord, it's by grace. We got what we deserve. It's that. It's at you, it's at me, but praise God for grace. Last week I shared about faith and those unexpected things that come in your life. And Jesus said, where is your faith? Praise God, we've got one we can count on. In the storm, in the trouble. Praise God, he's wonderful. But there's a... There's an element that's lacking in our world today. It's lacking in our nation. It's lacking in our churches, if I'll be honest, it's lacking in our churches. It's lacking in the life of those that say they're Christians. And you know what the Bible says here? It says it's something that we need to do, we need to confess Jesus Christ as Lord.
Yes.
He deserves to be lifted up this morning.
Amen.
The word Lord means supreme. He ought to be supreme in your life.
Right.
Yeah.
Not over somewhere else. Well, I need you now, Lord. He ought to be the supreme. Not only to be supreme, it means that's the one I belong to.
Amen.
You know what? If he looks down at me, he says, you're mine.
Right.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
He's Lord this morning. Now, whether you acknowledge him as Lord or not, he's still Lord, by the way.
Amen.
He's still on the throne. He is the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Jesus asked Peter, he asked him a question in Matthew 16, verse 13. He said, who do men say that I am? Yep. Well, he said, I heard some of them think you're John the Baptist, come back to life. Some of them think you're Elijah. Some of them think you're Jeremiah. There's others, if I could, as I thought about that, some thought, well, that's the carpenter's son over there. Others would say, he's the one who healed me.
Yeah.
By the way, he's a great healer.
That's right.
Amen.
Others would say, he's the Christ. He's the one who was the promised one. He's the anointed one. He's the Son of God, yes. And praise God, I hope this morning that you can say this morning that he's your Savior.
Amen.
Right.
He's the one, I think about the one they dropped down from the ceiling tiles. He had a physical problem. They knew about the great healer, but Jesus, the first thing he said to them, he said, your faith has made you whole. He said, your sins are forgiven.
Amen.
Isn't that a wonderful thing to have sins forgiven?
That is.
Boy, if you haven't had your sins forgiven, there ain't nothing better, nothing like it, amen. You can't erase it. You can't get rid of your sins. But praise God, there's a God in heaven that can take care of your sins. And this morning, yes, we can be here this morning, and we say, yes, he's my Savior.
Amen. Yes, he's my Savior.
Thank you.
By the way, everybody's looking, wants a Savior. A Savior's something that's great, isn't it?
Yeah.
I need saved out of something. And I'm going to tell you, God, my God, can take care of your something.
That's right.
Whatever your situation is, he's able to handle it. And pray, God, I need that Savior.
Yeah. Amen.
But you know what? There's a higher position that he deserves, and it's the Lord.
Right.
Hey.
Yeah.
You can't get a higher position than that. We want him as Savior, but do we really want him as Lord? I'm very concerned about this. I don't know. I've seen it. I've lived long enough now. I can see it. Folks, they want saved out of some situation. They want this or that. But Lord? Oh, Lord, fix this. Fix this for me. Can you imagine if the Lord said, I'll fix this, but what about being Lord of your life?
Right.
And we say, well, I want you to fix this, but you know, I still want to be in charge. I really don't want to listen to you, God. I tell you what, this morning, my Savior deserves to be Lord.
Amen.
He deserves to be lifted up. Amen. Praise the Lord. I know him as Savior this morning. Now, there's a lot of folks, I tell you what really bothers me, much of the world seems to think they're saved. Oh, yeah, I believe John 3:16, for God so loved the world, he gave his only. I believe in Jesus. And so this morning I want to warn you, just because you believe in Jesus does not mean you're saved.
That's right.
Amen.
And it bothers me. There's many that are deceived and say, well, you believe in Jesus, I'm a believer. You know what I want? You know what? The devil believes in Jesus.
That's right.
He ain't saved. And the devil has not done one thing. He has not acknowledged Jesus as Lord. I want you this morning, if you've not confessed him as Lord, I want you to confess him this morning as Lord.
Yeah.
Fact is, we know some very familiar verses in Romans chapter 10. We find that Paul tells us how to be saved. And Let me read here for you in Romans chapter 10, verse 9. Now notice what it said. You know, there's a lot of people out there, there's a lot of preachers, and a lot of things that go on. You know, I hear, if you don't read that, don't even listen to that internet stuff, I'm going to tell you what. Amen. You'll get on there and someone will say about this.
Amen.
Now I'm going to tell you what, I've heard a lot of folks, and you'll read some reading, they say, and you know, we have a gospel track back there, and it'll get down to the end, it'll have a little prayer on it. And you know, there's some folks that say, well, you ought not have a prayer on there. And they say, you're really deceiving people, well, with a prayer. You know what my Bible said right here? It says in verse 9, that if thou shalt confess. You know how you confess? It says, with your mouth.
Amen.
I can't think of a better way than praying, can you? So it says, it is confessed with thy mouth. Now I want you to know what it says here though in this verse. A lot of times we read through this and say, I believe Jesus, I love Jesus, I believe he's real, I know he's out there. But you know, we've never done this. It says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, now notice what it says. It doesn't say Jesus. It says Lord Jesus.
Right.
There's a difference, folks. There's a difference in going through life and saying, well, I'm all right, I'm okay. But there's a difference than acknowledging him as Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. He deserves to be Lord. Yes. The only reason you got any breath here this morning is because of him.
Amen.
The only reason you got anything is because of him.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
And boy, we think we deserve something. You don't deserve anything. You know why he created you? It was for his pleasure.
That's right.
That's why he did that. What's his life all about? It's not about you. It's about him. And we find here it says, if you confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead, I'm going to tell you what he lives.
Right.
Praise the Lord. Thou shalt be saved. Amen.
Hallelujah.
You can read down verse 13. That's a familiar verse we use. For whosoever shall call upon the name of who? The Lord. Shall be saved.
Amen.
Well, you'll find all throughout the Bible, you know, it's kind of amazing. Over 600 times in the New Testament, you'll find the word Lord. 182 times it says Lord Jesus. Many times it said Lord Jesus Christ. But you know what I want to point out there? They've acknowledged him as Lord.
Yeah.
You can go over to Matthew chapter 8, and a leper came, and they'll come down there, and you know what they called unto Jesus? They didn't say Jesus, they said Lord!
Amen.
You know, it's kind of interesting. Let me read it for you. I kind of, there's something else, just kind of a side note here, Matthew chapter 8, verse 2. It says, and behold, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord! It didn't say if thou art able.
Yeah.
He's able, folks.
Yeah. That's right.
He said, if thou wilt. Thou can make me clean. Amen. I just like that. It kind of stuck out this me in the morning as I was reviewing this. He didn't say you're not able. I don't know if you're able, God. You know he's able because he's Lord.
That's right.
Amen.
You'll find there in chapter 5, a centurion came to Jesus. He said, and notice what he said, Lord, they acknowledged him as Lord. And he said, I've got a problem. I've got a son. I've got a servant. I've got one. If you could touch him. He said, I know about having authority. I know what it is to be in charge. He said, you don't need to come. Just say it and it'll be done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what he knew him as? Lord.
That's right. Amen.
You find the disciples, I think I shared this last week, amen. They're on the boat there. The storm came in it. I tell you what, the waves came in. And you know what they said? By the way, Jesus is down. He's on board. Don't you forget he's on board, folks.
Yeah. Yeah.
And when they came to Jesus, you know what they said? Lord.
Yeah.
I tell you what, he can handle the storm.
Amen.
He's Lord this morning.
Yeah.
He deserves to be acknowledged Lord. You read on after Jesus calmed the storm. Didn't say who it was, but some looked there, and it really bothered me. It says, "What manner of man is this?"
Yeah.
That's what they said. I'm going to tell you, he's not a man. It's the God man.
Yeah.
It's the Lord man.
Amen.
God came down as man. He just ain't any other man. Right. You know what we do? We treat him just like a man.
That's right.
He needs to be treated as Lord this morning.
Amen.
Oh, how we need that. It really bothers me. It's been heavy on me this week. Our nation, we want a Savior. We want you to deliver us. We want you to help our economy. We want you to help this. But do we want Him as Lord? Boy, wouldn't it be good if we said, you need to be in charge?
Yeah. Amen.
Wouldn't that be good? We can bring that down to our own lives. Oh God, I need you here. I need you there. But this morning I want to ask you, is He Lord in your life? You know what? This hits me like a rock. Because you know what I have a problem with? I want to be in charge. You're all the same way. We all want to make our decisions. Well, I want to be the one, amen. But let me tell you what, He deserves, and He's not getting what's due credit Him. He deserves to be Lord.
Amen.
Help us, Lord, this morning. You can read on, and you find in Matthew 17, 15, there's a father came, and he said, my son, he's a lunatic. He falls down in the fire, and he came, and you know what he said? Lord! He said, would you help me? You find two blind men were on the side of the road, and you know what? They cried out to Jesus. They couldn't see Him, but they said, have mercy on us, O Lord. That's what they said.
Yeah.
I like Peter. Peter, he goes out there on, he said, boy, hallelujah. He had enough faith, and he said, Jesus, I want to walk in the water too. Then he went walking out there, and you know what happened? He took his eyes off Jesus. He started to sink.
Yeah.
But praise God, you know what he said?
Yeah.
He said, Lord, save me.
Yeah.
He knew he could do it.
Right.
Praise the Lord. I think about Stephen. Book of Acts chapter 7 verse 59 says, as they took up stones and they threw those stones at Stephen, you know what he said? Lord.
Yep.
He knew Him as Lord.
Yep.
He knew Him as Savior, but he also knew Him as Lord. He said, Lord, receive my spirit. You'll find all through the Bible, you'll find that praise God, you'll find it's all tied in with salvation. You'll find the Philippian jailer in Acts chapter 16. You know what Paul told the Philippian jailer to do? Well, here's what the Philippian jailer, all of a sudden he saw, boy, they're singing at night. What's going on? Those radical Christians, how can they be so happy? And all of a sudden the earth shook, amen. The bars came down, and amen, the Philippian jailer got convicted by God. And he said, what must I do to be saved? And you know what Paul said? Believe on the Lord.
That's right. Amen.
Jesus Christ. Believe on Him. Believe on the Lord. But you know what? We find, yes, at time and time that they confess the Lord. But you know, as I look in our world today, and I'm sure it's always been, we find a time again where they take the name of the Lord in vain.
That's right.
By the way, you know what the Bible said? Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord in vain.
Man.
And you know what? We often think, well, that's cursing or something. No. It's a whole lot more than that. It's a whole lot worse than cursing. When you take the name of the Lord in vain, you know, a lot of times, I like that, and I've said this before, a lot of times say, I'm a Christian. No, you're not. You know what they're doing? They're taking Christ's name in vain. And as many today, they'll say, Lord, He's not your Lord.
Right.
You just said He was, but you can tell you're the one who's in charge. He's not. And so that's taking the name of the Lord God in vain. You're taking His name in vain. You have nothing to do with it. You're saying, why are you using my name? You'll find in Matthew chapter 8, verse 21, Jesus said to one, He said, follow me. And you know what He said? Lord!
Yep.
He said, Lord, well, let me first go bury the dead. And you know, you say, well, that seems a little sad. You know, I mean, why wouldn't Jesus let him do that? Jesus said, let the dead bury the dead. Now, that seems pretty strong. But you know what? I don't believe the guy was dead yet. I believe his father wasn't dead yet. He said, well, someday when he dies, I'll have more time. I'll do it. No, that's not Lord. He called him Lord. When God wants you to do something, you ought to just do it. In Matthew 7:21, it said, not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven. He said, well, you prophesied, you did a lot of good things. And now you know what? I'm fearful of that. There's a lot of people today, they go to church, they do good things, and they say, Lord. But Lord knows better.
Yeah.
I haven't been Lord. And you know, that's a sad thing. That's a sad thing. The Bible said that, you know, he said, I never knew you. Ain't that awful? I said a prayer. He said, I never knew you.
Yeah.
I did a lot of good things, but I never knew you. I want to make sure that folks this morning, first of all, are saved. Sometimes they got trust, they trusted, and I'll ask folks if they've been saved. Well, I was baptized. Baptism didn't save you.
Right.
You better confess the Lord.
Amen.
Jesus said in Luke 6:46, they said, why call me Lord, Lord, and not do the things that I ask? You know what they're doing? They take the name of the Lord in vain. He goes on, he says, it's like a man that built his house upon a rock. He says, you know what? There's a foundation. But those that don't do what he says, it's like you built it on sand. I tell you what, he needs to be Lord in our life. He is a child of God. I'm a child of God. I know I'm saved. But you know what? If I don't keep him where he deserves to be, there's trouble on the horizon. You'll have trouble in your marriage. You'll have trouble at work. You'll have trouble in this. And yet we want to say, oh Lord, help me.
Right.
You put him on that throne where he deserves to be. Now you may not get everything you want, but I tell you, it's the best life you'll ever have.
Yeah. Right.
You know, it's kind of interesting. It's kind of like we're like children. Maybe a child will come to you and they'll say, I know my grandchildren are that way, amen. Mimi. Boy, I love that sound, don't you? Amen. They'll say, Mimi, you know, will you give me this? But there's times that Mimi has had to say, you've been bad. You ain't getting it. Now, can you imagine us? Here's what we do. We say, Lord, I need this. I need this. And you know what the Lord would whisper back and says, well, when are you going to make me Lord? When are you going to put me in charge? When am I going to be on the throne? When are you going to let me make the decisions in your life? You know, we all want saved, but we don't want to be Lord. We're all that way. Self gets in the way. And when self gets in the way, trouble comes. David, when he was going against that battle against Goliath, I'm going to tell you, and you know what he said was going to get Goliath? He said, the Lord's going to get you.
Yeah.
He knew who was supreme. He knew who was in charge. He was listening and obeying him. A few years later, you'll find, the very first verse says, in the days when kings were supposed to be in battle, David didn't go to battle. You know, if he'd have listened to the Lord, he'd have been in battle that day. But you know what happened that day? Sin entered in. And you know what, David, when I get to heaven, he's going to be in heaven. But you know what it did? It affected him the rest of his life. It affected his children. There's a lot of heartache a lot of times. Just because we don't listen to God. He needs to be Lord, amen. When I was young, I got associated. It's called a Crusade for Christ. And they had a little track. I tried my hardest to try and find it. I've had it for 30 years plus. And I couldn't find it. I was digging around in my desk down at home, and I couldn't find it. But it's a little tract. It's called The Four Spiritual Laws. Now, some folks don't like it. But there's something I like about it, amen. First of all, it says, number one, God loves you. Let me tell you, God loves you.
Amen.
He desires to have a relationship with us. Did you know that?
Yes.
But number two, it says that man is sinful. You know, we've all fall short of the glory of God. And you know, that separates us from God. That's a problem, isn't it? But you know what the third one says? There's one way that will get you back there. There's one that will fill the gap, and it's Jesus.
Amen.
And He's the only way.
Amen.
But it's the fourth one that's very debatable today. But here's what He tells them to do. He says, we must individually receive Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. A lot of folks don't like it. They just want to say, just Savior. I just read, if you confess with the mouth, what? The Lord. Isn't that what I read? Okay. Praise God, He's your Savior. I hope you, maybe you said, oh, He saved me. I tell you, many will say a prayer and say, ah, save me, Lord. If you save me, I'll do this or that. Amen. Hallelujah. And we never say, Lord, I want you to be Lord in my life. You know, I'm talking for the day I got saved. You know what I did? Now, has He's always been Lord in my life? No. But when I got saved, you know what I did? I said, I'm in trouble, Lord. I can't get out of this, Lord. I can't get rid of these sins, Lord. I know You can. And Lord, I'm tired of trying to be in charge. There's an illustration in the track, and I like it. I wish I had a big chair here like a throne. Now imagine this chair over here is the throne over here. And you know what? The one that's on the throne is the one that's in charge. Yeah. Now before you got saved, you know who's sitting here? And you know what I found out being in charge? I can't do it. You know what? Praise God. There's a day I realized I'm going to make a shift here. I'm going to change. And praise God, I got out of the way. And I said, Lord, You sit up here.
Right. Yeah. Amen.
Yeah. But you know, if we're honest, and first of all, I want you to be saved. He needs to be on the throne. Secondly, if you are saved, better make sure you keep Him on that throne. The Bible said He's coming on a white horse. I don't know how that's going to look, but I'm looking forward to it. It said the skies open up, and He's coming down, and on His vesture it said dipped in blood, and on the side it said King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I like the story there at Easter time we read that. You'll find there the angels talking to Mary, or the women there, and they made a statement that said, He's not here, for He is risen. Said, come see the place where the Lord lay. By the way, if He's still in the grave, He ain't Lord. But He's not in the grave, and He is Lord today. He deserves to be number one in your life.
Amen.
You know, if we're honest, and I mean, we got to get honest with ourselves. We got to really evaluate ourselves. And you know what we say? Well, I know the Lord wants me to do this, but I want to do what I want to do. I'm not going to do that today. Maybe next week. You know what? That's not Lord. He deserves a higher position. He deserves a rank. He deserves some respect. He deserves some honor. And I'm going to tell you what, He's not getting it. And you know what? He's got to start right here. I can say, well, our nation, they tell you what, that government, they need to put Him one. You know what? We need to put Him number one.
That's right.
I like that song, it's me, O Lord, standing in need of prayer. It's not my brother, not my sister. It's me. Yeah. And as I look at this, I realize, Lord, help me get out of the way. When I have a decision in my life, help me to come to You. Bible said, by the way, says we should follow Him. He's not following you around. You're supposed to follow Him. He is Lord. Let's all stand this morning. Oh, Father, this morning. The Bible said if we confess with our mouths the Lord Jesus, and Lord, maybe we came and we've confessed many things, but Lord, have we put You on the throne? Lord, where are You today? When we leave this place, so it's easy to say, oh, You're on the throne here, but when we leave this place, where are You? Do we look for you, Lord, when we just all of a sudden need you, when a trial or a storm comes? Lord, you deserve better than what I give you. Lord, I want to lift you up. I want you on that throne. Lord, I want to give you respect and honor than what you truly deserve. Lord, if we're honest, we fail in that area. Thank you for that grace. Thank you for that mercy. But my fear is there's many that maybe they said a prayer, but they never made him Lord. Did something wrong. Maybe they're trying to get out of a jam, a situation. But Lord, I know what you desire this morning is that you might be put on the throne. Help us to do that here this morning. Perhaps there's one here that's never been saved. Lord, they never confessed Jesus as Lord. Help them to realize they're in great need. And Jesus is the answer. He is the way. Have your way, Lord. Speak to our hearts in Jesus' precious name. Amen. With every head bowed and every eye closed. Is he Lord? Is he Lord? It's easy to say he's Lord. But who's calling the shots in your life? Who's getting this respect and the honor? Did we come this morning for him? Maybe we had other motives. He deserves a higher place, a higher plane. He deserves our obedience. Says, Lord, he's, yes, Lord, I'll listen to you. I'll do whatever you want. When's the last time you asked him what he wanted? Oh, is he Lord this morning? He's Lord whether you acknowledge him or not. But he wants to be in charge of your life, your decisions. He won't make a mistake. You will, but he won't.
Lord, as they're lost, we ask that you save them before it be too late, Lord. Father, again, we ask, Lord, that you help us, watch over us. Lord, we ask that you watch over our thoughts, our actions, our direct our thoughts always toward you in this life, Lord, in the precious word. Lord, we ask that you forgive us our sins and help us depart from evil. But it's in that precious and lovely name of Jesus that I pray and ask these things this morning. Amen.
Amen. Thanks, Brother Jack.